गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 9th द हाई बुक एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ योर चैप्टर द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक एंड दिस चैप्टर इज बेसिकली रिटन ऑन द लाइफ स्केच ऑफ द मास्टर ऑफ शहनाई मिस्टर उस्ताद बिस्मिल्लाह खान सो लिसन केयरफुली आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द बेसिक concept of the chapter. So the chapter says that Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in the royal residence for it had a shrill unpleasant sound. It means ki Aurangzeb in the court of Aurangzeb there was a musical instrument that was called Pungi. This was the harp instrument which create a very unpleasant or very harsh sound which was not good for the ears. It was not the pleasing. So Aurangzeb banned it completely from his royal court. It means now it was not allowed to play in his court. Pungi became the generic name for reed noise makers and the Pungi was notorious or ill famous for its unpleasant sound. Its sound was very harsh. Few had thought that it was one day be revived and the people expected that in the coming future there will be one day when Pungi will be improved and its sound will be very pleasant and good for the ears. A barber of a family of professional musicians who had access to the royal palace decide to improve the tonal quality of the Pungi. So in the court of Aurangzeb there was a barber family who have very expert in the instrumental designing. So the barber decided to improve the quality of Pungi. He decided to change the harsh tone of Pungi into melodious one. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the Pungi and made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. So what he have done, he have taken a long pipe, attached it in the middle and made 7 holes on a particular gap. And when the fingers were placed on these holes, the sound of the Pungi was now pleasant. It means it was not so harsh as it was earlier. When he played it on it, closing and opening some of these holes, soft and melodious sound were produced. So when after modifying the Pungi was played, it started to create or give the pleasant sound which was very melodious, which was very good for the hearing. He played an instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. So after listening this changed voice of the Pungi in the form of modified, it was the sound of the Pungi was produced was very impressive. The instrument so different from the Pungi had to be given a new name. So now the old Pungi was totally different from the new one. So there was need to give it a new name because it was not similar as it was in the form of Pungi. So there was the requirement to give it the new name. But there was the major question that what should be the new name? What should be the new name provided for this new instrument. As the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chambers and was played by a Nai barber, the instrument was named the Shahnai. It means this new instrument was firstly played in the court of Shah Alam I, the emperor of the Mughal dynasty, who was the successor of Aurangzeb, King Aurangzeb, and the instrument was modified by Barber, so it was named Shahnai. It means Shah and Nai. This was the combination of two words, Shah and Nai. And from since then, the name of Shahnai was popular, and thus it got its name. The song of Shahnai began to be considered auspicious. So, in our society, in Indian society, the Shahnai is known as the symbol of omens for the prosperity, and it is considered as the auspicious. So, it is always used to play in the very pious occasions like marriage party, tilak, and other such type of religious occasions or religious ceremonies. And this reason, it is still played in temples and an indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. So, in mostly in North India, at the time of marriage, it is think that it would be very auspicious that if we play Shahnai at the occasion of marriage. So, and besides this, in the temples, famous temples of India, it is also played at the prayer time. So, Shahnai have made a very good place in Indian society. The Shahnai was part of the Naubat or traditional assembles of nine instruments found at royal courts. So, there was nine instruments in the royal court. It means there were nine musical instruments were played in the royal court or in the court of the kings at that time. And the most significant musical instrument at that time was Shahnai. Till recently, it was used only in temples and weddings. The credit for bringing this instrument onto the classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. But in the earlier ages, the Shahnai was not so popular. But now we can see that there is a very respectful place in our society, in our life, the Shahnai have made. And the full credit goes to none another one, but it was only Ustad Bismillah Khan who have made this tremendous changes and bring the Shahnai to its climax. As a 5-year-old, Bismillah Khan played Gilli Danda near a pond in the ancient state of Dumrao in Bihar. So you know that there is a district in Bihar that is Buxar district. And in Buxar district, there is a small township area which is known as the Dumrao. So Bismillah Khan basically belonged to that place, Dumrao. So when he was 5-year-old, he used to play Gilli Danda, which is the very traditional play in the India and from ancient time. So he was playing Gilli Danda in his native village. He would regularly go to the nearby Bihariji temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaita at the end of which he would a big laddu weighted 1.25 kg, a prize given by local Maharaja. So there was a temple of Bihariji. So it was become the habit of Ustad Bismillah Khan that he regularly went to that particular temple and used to play musical instruments and sang a Bhojpuri form of song which is called Chaita. And he sang this song so melodiously, so impressively that the king of that time was very happy with his performance and awarded him with the 1.25 kg laddu. This happened 80 years ago, and this story is not of the modern life, but this is the story of 18 years ago. It was very old story, and the little boy has traveled far to earn the highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. So from starting of a child performer, and slowly he improved very tremendously. He polished his talent. He got expertise in playing Shehnai, and slowly he popularized the Shehnai not only in India but across the world. The near about 100 plus years he has spread the melody of the Shehnai, and he has given live performance in many countries like USA, Canada, Australia, UK, France, Germany and Japan, etc. So in these countries he has given performance. He played Shehnai and he made the people aware about this magical musical instrument. And finally, to see his great contribution in the field of music, the government of India have decided to award him with the highest civilian award of the country, Bharat Ratna. Born on 21st March 1916, Bismillah belonged to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar. So it was not very new or very extra thing for the Ustad Bismillah Khan. Whatsoever he have achieved, he have done in his life, that was inherited from his ancestors. In his family, his grandfathers, his father, his relatives were also involved in the field of music. So it was given to him in heritage. He have got it in heritage from his ancestors. His grandfather Rasul Bakhsh Khan was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's Court. So his grandfather Rasul Bakhsh was also engaged in the Bhojpur King's Court for playing Shehnai. His father Paigambar Bakhsh and other parental ancestors were also great Shehnai players. So it's not only about his grandparents, but his parental uncles, his maternal uncles, and his near about the mostly members of his family were involved in playing Shehnai. The young boy took to music early in life. So from the early stage of his life, he got the music. At the age of 3, when his mother took him to his maternal uncle's house in Banaras, Bismillah was fascinated watching his uncle practice the Shehnai. So when he was only 3 years old, his mother took him to his maternal uncle's home, and his maternal uncle's home was in Varanasi. At that time it was called Banaras, where he was to playing Shehnai to his maternal uncles, and he was so impressed, he was fascinated to see that how beautifully, how perfectionally his maternal uncles were playing Shehnai. Ali Bakhsh, the Vishnu temple of Banaras, Bakhsh was employed to play the Shehnai. So his maternal uncle Ali Bakhsh was engaged to play Shehnai in the famous Vishnu temple of Banaras. And one day he got opportunity to go there and see how his uncle was playing Shehnai in that temple. And finally he got this opportunity, went there and saw, and he was very impressed, he was very fascinated, he was very captivated to see that how beautifully, how melodiously his uncle was playing Shehnai in that Vishnu temple. So this was the first half of this chapter, and I hope that you have understood all the major and significant points of